YouTubers. Beckett is on his way. So a while back y'all saw a video where we bought a few muscadines and a couple grapes. And so today I'm going to set the post to start our trellises for the muscadine vines. And I'm gonna also review how I need to do the grapes. But the muscadines, for sure, in the research, 20 feet apart, the plants, and grow them 10 feet each direction. So I'm gonna set a wood post out here, sack-crete it, set a wood post out there, sack-crete it, and then there'll be a post in between and a post down beside each plant. And that'll just be a T-post that I can connect my wire to. I've purchased some wire, some 9-gauge wire with a 9-gauge wire, what they call a, I can't think of the name of it, but basically it runs in where it grips it and holds it so I can pull it tight. We'll pull us a wire tight so that we can run this vine. And we're doing that because those type muscadines, or muscadines in themselves, tend to grow better in that first 10 foot of section of vine. You can grow it up as high as these trees here if you want to and let it run up there. The difference is the muscadine has a harder time getting nutrition from there all the way to the end of that vine. So if we can get it in that first 10 feet, we can water it well, fertilize it well. Those 20 foot, 10 this way and 10 that way, will give us the best fruit. And the muscadines themselves, we can get, if they're healthy, 100 pounds of fruit per year per plant, on average, they say. So hopefully we can pull that off. But I do need to secure these pretty well. And so we're gonna put a concreted post so that when we pull that wire, it doesn't pull my post together and gives us a good solid wire to hold all that couple hundred pounds of fruit on over time. So that's what we're gonna do today. Hey, do you know if we have any T-posts?
I'm not sure, Eric. Bless you. She ain't got her fan.
It's a glorious thing.
Soil looks moist.
I was gonna say, didn't we get like 2+ inches of rain?
Yep. First time I was wanting to try to get this dirt. Maybe on ground, but was it too hard?
Well, you tell me what you need and I'll be your hands. What are you barking at?
Hole number two.
Crazy. Babe, it's already, the vines are already like intertwining on the...
Yeah, I'll take it more.
You want to try to get that off?
I can tell you, if you will do me a favor.
Huh?
We should have some T-posts somewhere. Don't we have some over there?
I'm not sure. I'll go look.
At the other end of the garden, where the where those tomato plants didn't make it. If there's two of them, I just need two. One for each plant, and we're gonna take that up.
Okay.
Put the T-post. We'll beat.
I was gonna say that's T-post, but it's only 4 foot T-post.
No, we need one that it'll grow all the way up to the height of the T-post and then come across.
Okay. Okay, we'll go get that. Okay, we got the T-post. We are heading back over to get them in the ground.
Hey, cheeky, cheeky, cheekies.
Hey, cheeky, cheeky, cheekies.
Don't hit them all there, tree.
Oh, sorry. Let's go in the shade. Oh, yeah.
It's like 30 degrees cooler in the shade.
It's so humid today. Everything's humid.
It's very sticky.
Very sticky. Oh, don't run in front of me, dog. You insane fella. All right, let's see.
Oakley.
Oakley, this way, baby. Come on.
Come on, dude.
Come on. Oh, a breeze. That feels so good.
But this is what happens when you're on a farm.
That's right. Things have to be done.
Oof.
Oh, 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 oh. Okay. Let's pull back to the shade and see what we can get done. Oof. Yes.
I got two.
The shade's moving over. That's nice.
Getting a measuring tape.
And I need to level in my hand.
You can't get that. You're not strong enough. Hey, big fella, show me your muscles. Woo! Big muscles. You gonna try to pick that thing up? I don't think you can. It's heavy. It weighs as much as you do.
Well, you pull it straight up and down. That way and the other way.
Get down. Get down.
Hang on, Beckett. Roughly right there. We'll adjust. Get it off. Watch out, Beckett.
Watch out, baby.
How tall is that going to be?
So these T-posts are going to go next to the vine themselves for the vine to go up. So we're going to hammer those in the ground. Perfect, he says.
I think these are 5 foot T posts. Probably total length. I want to get 6 foot. That's right, 6 foot T posts. Go ahead and set these real quick before I put those in the ground. All right, now.
Bag of sack crete.
I need a bag of sack crete, and you need to level in your hand.
Bake it back up. Curiosity. Look at him. He's curious. Ooh, he said. Of all the places, you come and stand right in front of me. I love you.
Good. me see that, buddy.
Can Uncle Johnny boy have that?
I'm gonna do that.
That's concrete. It's gonna dry hard. So he's poking it down there so there's no air bubbles. When he puts the water in there, it'll be nice and compact. You can hold it now.
Well, let's see.
Let's check it again.
Now?
Not yet. No, don't touch. Yeah, not yet. We're going to get some water and put on it. Yeah. Yeah. Anthony, you think you can do the water hose and get it ready?
I got it.
And then he can pour some water on it. Okay. Thank you.
Beckett, hand mommy the level one more time.
Hey Beckett, come get mommy this level right here.
Right here.
The red thing. The red thing. Can you get it, please?
James, I need the red thing. I want to make sure one more time before Uncle Eric pours water in that we've got it covered. Hand it here. Thank you.
Oakley.
Good.
Over here.
And good.
I see your wheels are turning. Is those wheels turning? Look at me. Are those wheels turning? Say
back
yep.
Up, please, you're on my toes.
Let me see. Let me see your.
Let Uncle Eric see the shovel.
Shovel.
If you understand, I don't know if you've heard, Beckett calls Eric Johnny Boy. And that's a nickname that both Eric and Stumpy both have had for each other for years. And so now that's what Beckett calls Uncle Eric.
Let that go.
Is Johnny Boy.
Come up here and do this one.
Which is the sweetest thing in the whole wide world. What happened?
Forgot to make sure.
I had it square.
As flush as I can get it to that post.
Look at that little mess. You drinking the water?
I put it on there.
Yeah, like that. There you go. You're a big help.
There you go.
Thank you.
So now what you doing, Uncle Ed?
Measuring stick.
Measuring stick or measuring tape?
Tape.
Actually, no. I'll just use my chest.
That works.
You heard that, people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What's that?
No need to use a measuring tape.
No need to use a measuring tape.
When you have
perfectly good pec muscles.
Chest.
To measure with.
A perfect chest.
Oh, yeah.
Can you even hold it?
It's
Now, is that what it's going to grow on, is the string?
No, no. I ordered wire.
Oh.
Let me see how high that is.
That is right, almost 4 foot.
Right. String.
You're good, Izzy Beezy. It's dipped a little bit on this side, below 4 foot. Okay, that's 4 foot.
All right, measure it. I just want to see if I need to put these posts on this side or that side. It looks like I need to hang them on this side of the plant. That's the reason I wanted to do that. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
So,
I hang this with a bug.
This side of the plant, it'll be right there. So I need to get tractor or and push these stops right here.
Well, the good thing about our 4 foot post is those little bamboo sticks are getting thin, so you could put the 4 foot post down beside it to help stabilize both sides if you wanted to.
Girlfriend, be quiet.
You could put it closer.
Girlfriend. Hey. 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 What are you doing? Silly.
Alright, so now we'll let these set good. When I get the wire and the anchors, I'll drill a hole through here where the string's at. Matter of fact, I need to mark it. So we'll drill the anchor, we'll pull the wire, we'll pull it through one side, we'll go to the other side with the tractor, we'll hook a come along to it. We'll tighten it up where the wire is good and tight, like this string. Once we get it tight enough, we'll leave enough hanging out here that we can twist that wire around the pole. We'll cut it off, twist it around that pole. We'll take some T-post clips, clip that wire to the T-post, and we'll have our
trellis.
We'll have our trellis. And then if we want to run irrigation, I can run a smaller wire about 18 inches off the ground, and you can hook a hose to it and have irrigation underneath it that your mower, when you're mowing, can mow underneath it, and it won't mess your irrigation up.
Yeah. So sounds like a plan.
That's what it'll look like. We might have to, that one post is a little further out where the plan is, but I think we can make it work once we get it on there.
So now, would we take like twine or something and kind of tie the plant to the T-post for it to work its way up the T-post?
Right now, all we're going to do is get a little piece of this twine. I may just use this white twine, and we'll just pull the plant to the post and just tie it lightly and allow it to run up the post, because once the plant gets up here, it'll get up to the top of this, then we'll pick the two best running vines, and we'll tie it. We'll snip the others off, tie it to this, then it'll run
to the
down
wire,
10 foot that way, go around 10 foot to this side, we'll have another 10 foot here, 10 foot, and then that'll be.
It won't be long, it'll get up there. Let's do this.
Now this is not plant, this is the bamboo. Okay.
I'm just going to use it to tie it to the
hold the plant straight up to here.
Now, what do you do with this? Does this just hang, or will you clip this at the bottom? Because you've got, I mean, those are some pretty strong branches.
I'll pull them up and let them grow up more. All right, folks, we got our pieces in. I got our wire in. So it's another day. I'm trying to get this up on an
evening
when it's
not raining.
And our post is set. Post is set. I've got a drill, a hole through this post. And then I'm gonna waller it out here.
So what's that little metal piece you have right there, Uncle Eric?
This little metal piece is it's a grip. It has something that grips the wire. So when I pull it, it's gonna pull this thing flush to the post and hold it in. So I'm hoping to get this fairly flush here. Something like that right there. And then when I pull this in, and so we're gonna take be able to pull wire that way. So we're going to pull, and Caleb's going to thread. There you go. Yeah, he might have to straighten it out. So Caleb's going to try to get this thread down to this into this thing. I might be able to do it easier this way. Push it through the pole, push it through there. We'll stick it through it. There we go. And then what I'm gonna do is pull just enough that I got enough wire left here to wrap around the pole. And I think that's probably gonna be a safe enough to go around it twice. So.
You think you'll get it twice with that much wire, or do you think you'll need a little more?
Yeah, it should work. Go a little bit more, Seth.
We got plenty of wire. Let's better.
Yeah, you're going. Right there. All right, and then watch the plant. Yep. I got it. And I'm going to pull a little more. We'll even it out. How much you got? I got about that much, but I'm going to pull this way.
When you pull the slack out, it'll be about even.
So now, what I'm gonna do since I don't have my come along, we can't find it for some reason. I'm gonna have to be real gentle with this. There we go. And then we'll take the wire. Put this to itself.
Did you do it around the pole and pull the pole?
The pole.
They have to tighten the wire.
I'm sorry, not the pole. Forgive me, I'm sorry, not the pole.
No. We just want to get this.
I'm sorry. I'm not even thinking.
And we just want to wrap it. Probably a little closer to the end.
Actually do it like that and then twist it.
Well, I want to do it closer to the end though, because I want to save some good wire.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Like that.
Yeah. Gonna go.
So we're just going to try to twist this wire on just a little bit. And I just want it snug so we can clip it to it.
That should be okay.
That gives us a little tightness. All right, so what I want you to do, Kev, is back up, and then when
you have a hammer, so when you pull this, this is gonna come out of this hole. Because it's not set fully
yeah,
set in there.
Yeah, I do. You can use the tapper to tap it back in.
What tapper?
I'm sorry, the big old claw. That level. This.
Yeah.
See how tight it is. Good reach. All right. All right. Oh!
Right, back up.
Feels pretty tight right there. So look, we'll take our clips.
Aren't our trees pretty? Look at them growing. They look so green after all the water.
I think the tension is just gonna hold it there, honestly.
Yeah, once you take it off.
Okay, so the clips have to go
that.
See, let's make sure this is the right height. I want it a little higher. Is that about chest high? Yeah. How many of those climbed?
Don't get much tighter than that. Got it clipped, y'all.
We got to get one more post. I think we may have another T post somewhere, so I can put it in the middle. You see, it's got to be able to hold 100 pounds. And I fat created that sucker.
2 foot into the ground.
Well, we'll see. It's fat created.
The only thing you can do is, if it starts getting slack, is to get you one of those, get you a brace post, put it underneath here, and then just push it.
Yeah.
But you won't have to do that until you start losing tension.
What's crazy is it's in concrete.
Well, how deep is it?
It's about 2 feet.
I would say that's not deep enough for something like this.
Yeah, maybe
when you're
not
putting that much force. I mean, there's probably 300-400 pounds of tension on this.
Yeah. Well, once we release it, maybe.
Oh, it's going to lose. You're going to lose some.
We'll see.
For sure.
It's our first time doing this, so.
Push, any push suggestions on the are line. More than welcome.
I'll pick this off.
Can we cut this other end?
Yeah.
Very famous Eric Wark tongue in the cheek look when we're concentrated.
Know. Maybe so. If this don't work, I'll come up with something else. So now once we put a T-post here and tighten it up, it'll help keep it secure. Right there for it to run. It'll give it extra support because it'll sit on that T-post instead of on bare line.
Yeah.
And like I said, if I have to,
see, next time, do one of these on the end that you're going to pull from. On the other end, do an eye bolt, like a long eye bolt with a big eye on the end, and then you put a nut and a washer on one side, and then you can pull it as tight as you want, and then if you ever lose slack, all you have to do is just tighten that eye bolt, and it'll pull your tension back.
That's a good idea.
Instead of having to break this loose and having to re-pull
new wire.
Yeah.
My son giving me some good ideas.
Correct. And if need be, if we need it, we can always run extra, we can run another line of wire.
Right. But this will...
like a second line for it to grow on.
We'll see. I mean, we're new at this, first time doing it, but we got wire up. And so now, as this vine grows, and it grows above here, we'll find the two ends, get the two dominant runners and let them run 10 foot this way, 10 foot that way. It'll meet that one run 10 foot. We get 100 pound of fruit in a few years off each one, 200 pounds of muscadines a year.
Now our next project, Uncle Eric,
is
the grapes.
Figuring out the grape situation. But I'll need one more T-post here, and that'll support this weight right here in the middle, because it'll put that on there, and here in between should be good and tight. All right, so we don't know if this is gonna work, but we're gonna give it a try.
Any great suggestions, comments, anything of that nature, let us know, and we will be happy to listen, because like I said, this is our first time.
I might have should have put the post another foot deeper in, like my son said, instead of just 2 feet in. But I thought with it just being, you know, four and a half feet above the ground, that 2 feet in the ground might work, but it is pulling on that post a little, and over time that may give. I don't know. Amazingly, this one's not pulling, it's just that one. But that's where we pulled this direction. But I would guess this over time, this wire may give a little bit, like my son said, so we'll see. If so, I could always, you know, try to untwist it off of this and pull it tight again a little bit more, because this thing, as long as you pull it one way, it should tighten. So, but we'll let you know as progress grows on these things, how they work. And thank y'all for watching. And God bless you. And we pray this works and that we get good rewards out of that. And then next phase will be figuring out how to do the grapes.
Yep.
And so it's gonna be a little different than this, I think, because they have to grow on a little different trellis. But I'm gonna research that some more and see. So if y'all got some ideas about that, you can shoot them to us from Perry Hill Farms. Perry Hill Farms. Thank you for watching. A simple life is a much more enjoyable life. God bless. Thank you.